Imagine that you have two routers with a tunnel in between them. One router has a 1 gigabit internet connection and the other has a 100 meg internet connection. It would be easy for the fast router to overwhelm the slow router, or rather the link between them. And that's simply because it can send traffic at a faster rate than the other router can receive it. The solution here is quite simple. We can just rate limit or shape the traffic that the fast router sends to the slower one. Where it gets more complicated is if you're using multipoint tunnels and multiple spokes. The spokes have different speeds, so a simple shaper won't be suitable. The solution to this is called virtual channels. A virtual channel lets us control the traffic that we send to a particular site. And we identify this traffic by using a firewall filter, and we'll see how that works later. Virtual channels are configured on the hub router only, not spoke sites. The spoke sites are configured completely as normal. The first step is to define the virtual channels. We need one for each of our sites, as well as an additional virtual channel for any traffic that doesn't match a specific site. Next, we create the virtual channel groups. Within the group, we assign settings to each channel. Each virtual channel here represents a remote site. In each of these VCs, we're configuring a scheduler map and a shaping rate. Normally we would do those on the interface, but when we use channels, we apply that here, and then we apply the channels to the interface. Note that when we do apply it to the interface, it's the group name, not each site, that we apply to the interface. And that associates that group with that interface. We have to use a firewall filter when it comes time to recognize or identify the particular traffic that goes to each site. So it's one single firewall filter, and each term represents one of those sites. And there's a term at the end, of course, to catch any traffic that hasn't matched anything. We are going to identify traffic by the destination site because we have a nice subnet scheme that's nice and easy to use, but you can match based on whatever you want, really. There are two actions. One is to assign the traffic to a particular virtual channel, and the other is simply to accept traffic. If we don't use the accept command, then traffic will be dropped because it is a firewall filter after all. And finally, we apply that to an interface as well, just like any other firewall filter. It's applied in the output direction because we're looking at traffic as it leaves our router. And it's also under the unit. So we're going to need to use the per unit scheduler. And that's all there is to how virtual channels work. I hope you've enjoyed watching it and I hope it's been useful to you. We'll see you again in another video.